Hi all, welcome to Tech Forum. In this video, let us see how to use Sonarlint connected mode with Eclipse and SonarQube server running inside the Docker container to perform the code quality analysis. In our earlier video, we have seen how to set up SonarQube server inside the Docker container and bootstrap the required quality configurations. Refer to this video to set up the SonarQube server inside the Docker container and bootstrap the quality configurations. Let me quickly start the SonarQube server with this Docker image. So we discussed this in our earlier video. You can refer that. So let me go and execute this specific command. Docker run, then SonarQube, the port number 9000. I'm enabling the required mount point for data and logs. I'm going to use WSL to execute this command. So using this MNT here, the MNT mount point, then specifying the admin password, welcome one, also the image name. Let me execute the command. I'm going here to WSL and just to execute. Now the SonarQube server is ready. We'll be able to access through console. Let me go here and access it. Localhost 9000. Let me enter admin welcome one. The required quality gates and quality profiles are configured. If I go to quality gates, I can find AEM. It's a default. Same way, quality profile. This all details we discussed in earlier video. Please refer that. Sonarlint is an IDE extension that helps you to detect and fix quality issues while you write the code. Let us now see how to enable Sonarlint extension for Eclipse. In Eclipse, go to help, then click on this Eclipse marketplace. Search for Sonarlint. I already installed. If you are not installed, you can install this Sonarlint plugin. This extension or plugin is available for most of the editors. The Sonarlint works in two modes. One is standalone mode without integrating to SonarQube server. In this mode, only the standard rules are considered for quality analysis. There is no option to add custom rules. The another option is connected mode. Sonarlint is connected to SonarQube server. In this mode, the Sonarlint use the quality profiles and rules defined in the SonarQube server to analyze the code. I have a sample project. Let me quickly run the Sonarlint plugin. This shows the standard issues, maybe in the core. Let me Sonarlint, then let me analyze. If you go to the Sonarlint report, you can see all these issues. Also, like there is an option called Sonarlint on the fly. Whenever you write a code, the issues will be reported here. So again, if you want to see some Sonarlint rule description, you can select the rule and it will display the description or details here. All this console view, you can select from here, go to window, then show view, other. Then you can type Sonar here, Sonar, yeah. You can select all this view, Sonarlint bindings, issue location, on the fly report and rule description. Yeah, even you can view the Sonarlint console here. In the console, if you go here, you can select this Sonarlint console. Then you can select what kind of log data it should be, verbose output and analysis log. You can select both. Yeah, here this used all the standard rules, whatever the rules Sonarlint enabled with. This would be enough if you are using only the standard rules, but most of the cases, we may need project specific rules to establish the required quality standards. We have enabled some of the custom rule plugins in the SonarQube server, but those rules cannot be used in Sonarlint with standard mode. Let us now see how to enable the connected mode. As a first step, create a project in SonarQube server. For that, go here, projects, create new project, then enter some project key. So as I am using Maven project, I should be entering this group ID colon artifact ID. Let me copy this. Yeah, this is the one. Then click on setup. Yeah, even you can generate a token, or even you can use the username password, but let me create a token test, enter some name, then generate. Yeah, this is fine now. This project helps us to apply the required quality profiles and quality gates. Let us now configure the connected mode in Eclipse. For that, go into this Sonarlint bindings. Then click on connect to SonarQube/SonarCloud. Now we are using SonarQube. connect to a server, then enter the URL http://localhost, then port number 9000. That's fine. I click on next. Yeah, here you can use either token or username password. Because we already generated the token, we can use that. Let me go here and copy this token. Okay. Fine. Click next. Yeah, connection name, leave it to localhost. That's fine. Yeah, connection successfully created. Click on finish. This is fine. Yeah, now you need to select the projects to bind. So here the project means whatever the project in Eclipse should be binded to the project in SonarQube server. So let me click add. So I am going to bind this core. Then one more project I am going to bind is this apps. So fine now. Click on next. Yeah, now we need to link the project in SonarQube. So you can use any name, different name, but I created the same name. So repo, yeah, it will list that project. It's fine. Click on finish. Yeah, now if you go to this console, you can see all these rules are getting downloaded now. So yeah, all those custom rules, including the custom rules, things are getting loaded now. If I go and find out, I can. Yeah, this is my custom rule STL. Also, we have some sonar way. Yeah, this one AEM way Java. This also custom rule. So this is fine now. Now, if you want to update the bindings of all the project, you can just say right click, update all project bindings. So it will the additional rules or new rules, whatever you defined in the server, will get downloaded to this Sonarlint. Yeah, even you can bind a new project here. If you want, you can bind. Also, like if you want individual project, you need to unbind. You can go here and just to say unbind this project. Let us now quickly analyze the project. Maybe right click and say Sonarlint analyze. Yeah, even for the Sonarlint on the fly. But yeah, if you see this one, optional is defined as default injection strategy. If I go here and see that rule description. So it's a custom rule. It's defined by custom plugin. AEM rules, AEM 16. So same way, if I go to this one, avoid using annotation at test. This is again a custom rule. If I go here, yeah, it's saying like custom project rules, avoid annotation. So what does that mean is in the connected mode, whatever the rules and profiles we enabled in the SonarQube server will get applied in the Sonarlint. But in the standard mode, only the standard rules will get applied. Let us now see the review details in SonarQube console. If you see here, the report is not sent to the SonarQube server. The issue is only reported in the Eclipse editor. SonarQube scanner should be used to analyze the code and to send the report to SonarQube server. Let us quickly see how to analyze the Maven project and send the details to SonarQube server if required. Here we are using the scanner based on Maven. So if you see here, MVN clean install. Then we are specifying the sonar.login/admin, sonar.password welcome one. You can skip this if it is default password, but we changed it. So we need to specify this. Then sonar:sonar, this is the scanner. So let me quickly run it. Now the scanning is completed. Let us go to the SonarQube console. So let me go here. Yeah, if you see that already this project is loaded now. So it's again, the quality gate is failed based on our definition. Also, you can see the issues, reported issues here. So now let me go to the issues here. Yeah, if you see the list of issues here, but if you go here, like you can see a difference with this report. If I come down, yeah, if you see here, there's two issues. One is avoid using unsafe display context. This disables XSS protection. These two issues, somehow it was not displayed in the Sonarlint. The reason is these rules are enabled through custom plugin, also custom analyzer. Somehow Sonarlint won't support the rules based on custom analyzer. So that is the reason these rules are skipped while running from Sonarlint. So only option is you need to review those kind of rules through the SonarQube console. The main reason for enabling this through the custom analyzer is the file format is totally different. It is based on a HTML template. By default, analyzers won't support. So we should be creating a custom analyzer. But the trouble with that is Sonarlint won't apply those rules, the rules created through custom analyzer. Let us quickly see the files, contains the issues enabled through the custom analyzer. So these are all the files. custom header libs. So this is a different templating language. So also the issue is here, like context equal to unsafe is not be specified as unsafe. Also these files are under this UI apps. We already binded this project. If you see here, it's binded. Sonarlint, yeah, it's binded. So it's showing the option unbind. But still the issues are not reported. Yeah, whenever you have this kind of custom analyzer based issues, the Sonarlint won't help. So you should be using directly the SonarQube console. The connected mode along with SonarQube server in Docker container helps the developers to quickly set up the project specific quality standards and analyze the code as you write. Also, this is very useful to set up the consistent quality rules across the development team. That's all for today. Thanks all for watching the video. See you in the next video.